हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. वेलकम टू द ई क्लास ऑफ अकाउंट्स. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टूडे विथ पार्ट टू चैप्टर फोर. इफ यू कैन चेक आउट अ वेरी इजी चैप्टर. समटाइम्स यू माइट बी सेइंग सेट कि यू नो इट्स डिफिकल्ट वन. नो नो, क्वाइट इजी, वेरी इजी स्कोरिंग मार्क्स. ओके, मार्क एलोकेशन. लुकिंग टू मार्क एलोकेशन, यू हैव वन मार्कर थ्योरी. And you even have a four marker practical sum from this chapter. But very easy four marker if we and in reduced syllabus even more easy. Let us check what is included and what is not included. If you will open your textbook page number 153, you will see that in index the above I have mentioned the points. Point number 3, 4, 7, 8 and so on. These points are not included. They have reduced a lot from this chapter. Yeah, we need to go for practicals of both comparative statement and common size statement. But which type of questions? See, only simple questions are included of both the types, comparative as well as common size. Now, looking to this, I will even clarify to you missing information to questions, so information. Missing information questions are totally erased from this year, okay, only for this current year due to COVID. Now, coming to the question numbers which are not included, that also I have shown you on screen, you can note down. Once again, you can note down here very nicely, a missing information wale question. Question number, textbook question 8, 10, 12, not included, okay. Even illustration 17, 18, 19, 20. Even 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Comparative and common size. Missing information questions and illustrations I have mentioned which are not included in current year syllabus. Let us start with the chapter. Okay. First we need to know about meaning of financial statements. Normally, normal sense. Financial statements are those statements which provide result of different financial aspects of entity. Entity means business form. Okay. That is by making use of financial statements such as trading, PL, balance sheet. These are the statements which provide result of the different financial aspects. Okay. That we have to keep one liner in mind. What do we mean by financial statement? Even we can say this way that financial statements are such which disclose detailed financial condition of firm. Detailed financial condition of firm. So in this connection, let us look to the objectives. First objective is to know definitely profit and loss of business entity. Even to know the financial position of business entity. Third and not the last, to know the cash position of business entity. These are the basic three objectives. This though you know, we prepare final accounts so you have idea. Why we prepare these statements? That is to know the PL, to know the financial position through its assets and liabilities. Even cash position is known. Here, more deeply about cash position can be known with by preparing the cash statements, which we will understand cash flow statement last chapter of this part. Let us move on and get more idea about which statement fulfills which objective for MCQ point of view also. Like income statement is prepared to know the PL of a specific period. All of us practically have done, so we are able to connect very easily. Even balance sheet is prepared to know the financial position. Cash flow statement, as I told you, we will learn this concept completely. To know inflow and even outflow of cash. Total incoming and outgoing of cash will be known with this. So, which is the statement and what is the objective of it we have known. I would even add something more to it. After this objectives or significance, you can, one more thing you need to understand is what do we mean by financial statement analysis? Normally, the process of इंटरप्रिटेशन इज नोन एज एनालिसिस। हम लोग जब इंटरप्रिटेट करते हैं इन स्टेटमेंट्स में, इन दीज स्टेटमेंट्स वॉट एवर इंफॉर्मेशन इज अवेलेबल, व्हेन वी इंटरप्रिटेट दिस इंफॉर्मेशन मीन्स वी ट्राई टू इन्वेस्टिगेट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस इंफॉर्मेशन, देन दिस इज नोन एज एनालिसिस। एंड द इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द इंफॉर्मेशन दैट इज रिजल्ट गिवन इन द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट इज नथिंग बट द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट एनालिसिस, means we are trying to get the result over it. Please see to it that detailed meaning of financial statement analysis we need to know. First of all, financial statement represents the information and the results of business firm. What does it show? It gives the information and even the result of a business firm. Now, after preparation of financial statements, they are arranged in such a way that they become comparable. You know, in this minimum 2 years information is given, aap compare kar sakte hain with the 1 year's, in 1 year's information is compared with the second year. Not only this much, different stakeholders, who are they? Normally creditors, employees, customers, potential investors, government organizations, so many stakeholders are there. Different stakeholders take their decision on the basis of the financial statements which are prepared in a comparable form. Okay, so this way the entire process of this is known as analysis. Okay, so this full process itself is known as analysis. When different agencies make use of these statements and take decisions on the basis of these statements which are available in the comparable form, the process is known as analysis. Once again, after preparation of final accounts, they are arranged in such a way that they become comparable. When different parties take decisions on the basis of this financial statement, then this process itself is known as analysis. I hope this concept is clear. Moving on to another concept of this chapter, very important, again given in textbook also very nicely on page number 156, types of financial analysis. Very important for the theory and MCQ, even knowledge for the further studies. See, basically three types of financial analysis are there: on the basis of stakeholders, on the basis of, or you can say horizontal or vertical type, and then on the basis of duration, that is long, short. Okay, now first we will take a brief look on the basis of the stakeholders. Once again, let me tell you, stakeholders are what? Those are the parties which are directly, indirectly connected to the business world. They make use of the financial statement for their decisions. Okay, so that is analysis. So let us see, there are two parties. Naturally, some of them are internal parties and some of them are external. So on the basis of stakeholders, the you can say financial analysis can be divided into two parts: analysis on the basis of external, analysis done by the internal parties. First, external, the analysis which is done by potential investor, by financial institutes, by government agencies, by our credit rating agencies, or even by our researchers. Such type is known as the financial analysis done by external, or it is directly termed as external analysis. Is analysis ko kya bolte hain? External analysis. The analysis which is done by the outside parties. Same manner, the analysis which is done by management for decisions or informations so that they can go in and work the firm in an accurate way, or work in the firm in an elaborated way, then this type of analysis done by the management from the accounts which they have prepared for future development, then such type of analysis is known as internal analysis. So this way we have covered first category, types on the basis of type of analysis on the basis of stakeholder 2, external, internal. Let us move on. Another two, what are they? Horizontal, vertical. See, analysis on the basis of in form, it is known as, on the basis of form. Horizontal form, vertical form. Let us understand it. Horizontal analysis. The analysis of which financial statement, when the comparison of financial statements of different years is known as horizontal analysis. When the analysis is done of different years, though alag alag years ki analysis information ko analyze karte hain, to usko bolte hain kaun si? Horizontal analysis. Now, normally, this analysis is done for long-term planning of the business. Long-term planning ke liye ki jaati hai. It is even useful to know the current trend. Okay? That's why this type of is even known as, another name is given to it, time series analysis. Kya naam hai? Time series analysis. Okay? Because it allows us to know the current trend. अब क्या ट्रेंड चल रहा है, राइट, क्या चेंजेस आई हैं, ओके, दो साल में कंपेयर करके. दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज इवन नोन एज टाइम सीरीज एनालिसिस. वंस अगेन, हॉरिजॉन्टल एनालिसिस व्हिच इज डन फॉर द बिटवीन डिफरेंट इयर्स, इट इज डन फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म प्लानिंग ऑफ बिजनेस एंड यूज टू नो द, इट इज यूज टू नो द करंट ट्रेंड ऑफ बिजनेस. दैट्स व्हाई अनदर ट्रेंड नेम ऑफ इट इज टाइम सीरीज एनालिसिस. Another one, vertical form. Now, when in any analysis, only 1 year's information is used. When analysis is done between the different department of same unit. Unit wahi hai, uske different departments mein jab analysis kiya jata hai, then that analysis is known as vertical analysis. In the, where 1 year's information only is used. Okay. Now, this analysis is between different departments or different units of same firm, same year. That's why this is known as which analysis? Vertical analysis. While in this, so if we try to compare, in this minimum 2 years information is taken. So, this is horizontal. In this, 1 year's information is there. This analysis normally is done between different years, same year, one different departments of the unit. Okay, it shows the trend, or it, that's why another name is time series. So many important things we have learned, and this was the type of analysis on the basis of form, horizontal form, different or vertical form. This was the second. Let us go to the third. Third type is on the basis of duration, long term, short term. Let us understand what is given in this type of analysis. Here, long term, analysis is the analysis which are done from the information for more than 1 year. Ek se zyada year ki information use hoti hai. Normally, this type of analysis is done so that solvency and profitability business of the business can be understood. Okay, long-term solvency, profitability, liquidity, efficiency, that can be known in under this type of analysis. Normally, it is used by stakeholders, potential investors. Normally, outsiders, aap aisa keh sakte hain, stakeholders, potential investors, they all check. Okay, they check the through this before coming to the firm. More than 1 year's information is required. Let us go to another short term. Short term analysis. Short term here analysis is checking of solvency and liquidity. But for how much period? Short term. This is less than, this is known as short terms. Now working less than 12 months time period. In this, okay, 12 months and more than that. You are less than 12 months out. Within 12 months, ek hi saal ke andar nikalte hain. Short term solvency, normally solvency and liquidity is checked in this, and normally it is checked by money lenders, suppliers of raw material who give us short term credit. Toda time ke liye credit dete hain. Paisa unka safe hai. They will get back the amount that they check through this. So in all, we have done types, three types, on the basis of stakeholders, external, internal, on the basis of form, horizontal, vertical, on the basis of duration, long term, short term. Okay, let us move on. See, different tools of analysis of financial statements are there. Analyze karein to kaise karein? There are different tools which we will understand within our syllabus. One is comparative statement, another is common size statement, which we will do practical within this chapter, chapter number 4. But then next one, that is ratio analysis, is also one tool or financial statement analysis. This we will do in chapter number 5. Next follow up chapter mein isko hum use karenge. Okay, so let us go for it and check out what do we mean by comparative type. Type of comparative financial statements, normally the types of comparative financial statements are do tarike se ho sakte hain. Comparative balance sheet, comparative income statement. When we do analysis from P on the basis of profit and loss or income statement. Okay, another comparative on the basis of balance sheet. In this PL information is taken as the base of comparison. In this, balance sheet information is taken as the base of comparison. Okay, so let us get in details of it. Comparative financial statements. When comparative study of financial statement is then by comparing the information of the financial statement of the business of current year's information with the previous year's financial statement, that type of statements are known as comparative financial statement. Seedhi si baat hai, do year ki information chahiye, ek year ki current year ki information ko previous year ki information se hum jab compare karte hain, then it is known as comparative financial statements. Let us look into the features of it. First, a comparative statement adds meaning to the data. Ek ko dusre se compare karte hain to aapko pata chalta hai exactly what has happened in gap of 1 year. It is used to effectively measure the conduct of the business. It is used for the intra-firm analysis and inter-firm analysis. One firm with another firm also can be compared. Same firms, one information with the another firm can. So intra firm and inter firm, both analysis are possible here. A comparative statement analysis indicates what? Change in the amount as well as change in the percentage. When we will find difference, na? Difference will be found in both. Jab practical karenge to idea aayegi. अमाउंट में भी चेंज पता चलेगा एंड परसेंटेज कितना चेंज आया, बोथ आर नोन. सो इट इज अ हाईलाइटिंग फीचर ऑफ इट. नेक्स्ट, इट इज अ पॉपुलर टूल नॉर्मली यूज टू एनालाइज द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट. कंपेरेटिव एनालिसिस कैन नॉट बी यूज फॉर मोर देन 2 years फाइनेंशियल डेटा. कंपेरिजन इज टू बी डन बिटवीन 2 years फाइनेंशियल डेटा विच बिकम्स convenient and it becomes more meaning. Only 2 years information, when 1 year's information is compared with the another inter firm, it is there. So that has been a feature of it. Let us look into now first one of it. Pehle hum PL wala lenge, uska practical dekhenge, fir balance sheet ke bare mein seekhenge, uska practical karenge. We will move on step. Abhi hum sirf ek hi pe hain, comparative. Then next we will go later on common size. Let us see first comparative income statement. Income statement means PL ke base mein. The income statement or PL provides the result of operations of business. We get the result whether the business is going into profit or not. It includes all net sales, cost of goods sold, selling expenses, office expenses. We all know very well about this thing. Now, what I mean to say here, a comparative income statement gives the idea of the progress of the business over a period of time. Ek time gap mein business mein kitna changes aaya, kitna progress kiya hai. Now this is in the form of money value also, amount also, and even in the form of percentage is determined. तो एनालिसिस ऑफ प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी ऑफ बिजनेस इन बोथ द वेज वी विल गेट फ्रॉम दिस स्टेटमेंट्स, लेट अस चेक इट फॉर्मेट. कितना सिंपल सा है. सी दिस इज द फॉर्मेट और स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इट गिवन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक. इफ यू विल गो टू योर टेक्स्ट बुक नाउ यू विल गेट दिस फॉर्मेट ऑन पेज नंबर 166. ओके, बहुत इजी. देखो क्वेश्चन में पूरा पीएल का जो हमने ऑलरेडी चैप्टर 3 कंपनी किया है, सो इट बिकम्स वेरी कंफर्टेबल फॉर अस. थर्ड चैप्टर्स नॉलेज इज रिक्वायर्ड टू गो फॉर इट. इजी हो जाता है फॉर्मेट. सी प्रीवियस ईयर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड करंट ईयर इंफॉर्मेशन. ओनली सी टू इट दैट प्रीवियस ईयर्स इज पुट इन फर्स्ट कॉलम. पहले कॉलम में क्या लिखते हैं अपन, प्रीवियस ईयर की इंफॉर्मेशन, एंड देन इन दिस करंट ईयर्स इंफॉर्मेशन. देन द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज बोथ, 4 में से 3 को माइनस करेंगे, इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज इन अमाउंट, एंड देन द इंक्रीज डिक्रीज डिवाइड बाय प्रीवियस ईयर्स अमाउंट अपॉन 100 परसेंटेज डिफरेंस. इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज इन परसेंटेज. कॉलम 5 इंफॉर्मेशन डिवाइड बाय कॉलम 3 इज इंफॉर्मेशन इन टू 100. परसेंटेज में कितना वेरी इंक्रीज डिक्रीज हुआ दैट वी गेट. बस फॉर्मेट इज वेरी वेल विथ यू. ये सब सो सिंपल इट इज. इफ यू सी क्या नॉर्मली सेल्स अदर इनकम टोटल इनकम, फोर्थ स्टेज एक्सपेंसेस, कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड्स सोल्ड, नेट परचेजेस, चेंजेस इन स्टॉक, एम्प्लॉई बेनिफिट एक्सपेंसेस, फाइनेंशियल कॉस्ट, डिप्रिसिएशन एमोर्टाइजेशन, अदर एक्सपेंसेस, ऑल ऑफ दिस आर नोन टू यू. टोटल एक्सपेंसेस है, जब रेवेन्यू में से एक्सपेंस माइनस होते हैं यू गेट प्रॉफिट बिफोर टैक्स. दिस ऑल इन्फॉर्मेशन विल बी गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. ओनली वी हैव टू लिफ्ट एंड पुट इट. ये याद रखना, खाली उठा के रखना है और हमको कैलकुलेट एक्चुअली जो करना है दैट इज कॉलम नंबर 5 एंड कॉलम नंबर 6. दिस इज टू बी प्रेजेंटेड ओनली एंड दिस विल हैव वी हैव टू गो फॉर कैलकुलेशन. तो एक सम उठा लेंगे और उसको प्रैक्टिकली करके देखेंगे. We will have to go for this column, increase and decrease in rupees and then in percentage. Percentage के लिए column 5 divide by base year means previous year into 100. So simple, it has to be like that. Okay, so we will do practical sum for it. Thank you. Let us go for practical.